welcome. You're watching YOYO TV English and I'm Sheena Saluja. Well, Tamil Nadu's caretaker Chief Minister O Panneerselvam said he had not seen J Jayalalithaa even once in Chennai's Apollo Hospital where she died on December 5th. Apparently, he had been visiting the hospital daily to enquire about her health but couldn't meet her. Here's what more he said. Had visited the hospital daily to enquire about Jayalalitha's health condition but couldn't meet her even once. He told reporters that every day my family would ask, "Did you see Amma at Apollo?" I even considered saying yes, but I couldn't lie, he said. Ms. Jayalalithaa was admitted to hospital for breathlessness in September and was since then seen by a very selected group of people that included her longtime companion VK Sasikala, who took charge of the AIADMK days after her death and was chosen this weekend to take over from Mr. Panneerselvam as the Chief Minister. Panneerselvam, aging 66, said that he had doubts about Ms. Jayalalitha's treatment which needed to be answered. He is the second leader to raise question hours after PH Pandian, another AIADMK veteran, suggested that the former Chief Minister's death was not from natural causes. Always the quiet loyalist who worked only with Ms. Jayalalitha's photo by his side, Mr. Panneerselvam last night declared that he was her chosen successor and had been forced to resign by Ms. Sasikala, a long-time companion of the former Chief Minister. Soon after his bombshell, Ms. Sasikala summoned party legislator late at night at the Post Garden home she shared with Ms. Jayalalithaa. Later, she announced that she had majority support and Mr. Panneerselvam would be expelled. AIADMK leader M. Thambidurai has also ruled out any split in the party, calling Mr. Panneerselvam a lone player. On speculation that Panneerselvam had been edged on the rival DMK and the BJP, he posted, "I have no connections with the BJP and my actions are my personal decisions."